गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी स्टडी अबाउट द कम्युनिटी डायनेमिक्स। कम्युनिटी इज डिफाइंड एज ए ग्रुप ऑफ सेवरल स्पीसीज ऑफ प्लांट्स एंड एनिमल्स लिविंग टुगेदर विथ नेचुरल टॉलरेंस एंड बेनिफिशियल इंटरेक्शन विथ नेचर इज कॉल्ड कम्युनिटी। On this planet, no organism, whether plant or animal, never lives isolated. In nature, different kinds of organisms grow in association with each other. In any habitat, whether terrestrial or aquatic, vegetation is formed by species growing there. A community may be primarily of plants, but most communities include both plants and animals. A community may be large or small. In a community or communities, plants and animals of different species interact between themselves and with their physical environment. Communities interact between themselves and with their physical environments. Generally speaking, the biotic and abiotic components are in tune with one another. Communities differ from place to place and at the same place at different times. The biotic community of rainforest is very different from that of desert. So it is that of plains from that of the mountains. Major communities like large lakes, swamps, deserts, forests, grassland are relatively independent, while minor communities are dependent on adjacent communities. The environment gradient determines the degree of transition of one community into another. Blending of one community into another indicates continuance of vegetation. Then the characteristics of community. Like population, a community too has its own characteristics which are not shown by its individual component species. The characteristics are as follows. First one, species abundance and diversity, which is again subdivided into regional diversity and local diversity. Second one, growth form and structure. Third one, dominance. Fourth one, succession. And last, that is trophic structure. Now the first one, species abundance and diversity. Each community is made up of much different organisms, plants, animals, microbes, which differ taxonomically from each other. The number of species and population abundance is in a community also vary greatly. There are two levels of species diversity. Number one, regional diversity, and second, local diversity. In regional diversity of whole nation or parts of continent within which many different communities exist. In local diversity, in a given nation where different communities exist at different latitudes. Second one, growth form and structure. Community is described in terms of major growth forms as trees, shrubs, herbs, mosses, etc. In each growth form, as in tree, there may be different kinds of plants as broadleaf trees, evergreen trees, etc. These different growth forms determine the structural pattern of a community. According to the mode of arrangement of various growth forms, the communities exhibit zonation, that is horizontal layering, as well as stratification, that is vertical layering. Third one, dominance. In each community, all the species are not equally important. There are relatively only a few of these which determine the nature of the community. These few species exert a major controlling influence on the community. Such species are known as dominant. For example, in sal forest, it is dominated by sal trees, that is Shorea robusta, or teak forest is dominated by teak or Tectona grandis. Then fourth one, succession. Each community has its own development history. It develops as a result of a directional change in it with time. And last one, character is trophic structure, that is self-sufficiency. Nutritionally, each community, a group of autotrophic plants as well as heterotrophic animals, exists as a self-sufficient, perfectly balanced assemblage of organisms. This is all about the definition of community and characteristics of community. Thank you.